Hello everyone, in this video we are just going to learn how you can update a command in this talkback queue of ThingSpeak server by sending a put request from our Node MCU. Let's get started. Now initially let's try to do it manually with the help of Postman application. So this is the put request that is useful for updating the command in the talkback queue, right? I am just copying this and I am pasting it over here in the Postman. Now here I am just going to place a question mark between this JSON and API key. And at the end, I'm just going to concatenate the string command underscore string is equal to L9 and change the request to be put. As we know, put is the HTTP request required for updating a talkback command. And the command that I want to change is this command ID 2333-2433. So in my Postman, I just want to change this command ID to be 2333-2433. Now what happens is when I send this put request, the command L1 available here in this ID 2333-2433 will be changed to L9. You can see when I send this, the L9 has been placed in this ID. Now when I refresh this, you can see I get the command L9 in the command ID 2333-2433. Again, when I send another command, let's say to be L4, I will get the command string L4 placed in the same command ID. You can see it becomes L4. So this is the format request for updating a command in the talkback queue. So this is the API request for updating a command in talkback queue, and this is of the type put. And we are just going to try to send this put request with the help of Node MCU from our Arduino programming. And now you can see this is the same program that we wrote for adding a talkback command in the adding a talkback command lecture. So since this is using a post request, we are just going to alter this program for sending a put request for updating the command available in this command ID 2333-2433. So I'm just copying this URL from the Postman app and I'm going to paste it right over here in the top. And as usual, this HTTPS format is not supported by Node MCU. I'm just deleting this S. And the only difference between this command, that is the host name, and this host name is that additionally we are having this command ID. I am just copying this and I am pasting it over here. And then you can see this is the same. We just want to add the header content type. And then I am just changing this to be put message instead of post message. I don't want it to be post because we are just using the put request. And you can see, other than that, all these things are common. That is, this API key ampersand of command string is equal to. So this API key command string is equal to, and this command over here is given as a parameter to this function and it is added over here. And that's it. And once done, we just want to change this method post to put. Since we are going to send a put request, we are just using the method called put instead of post. And other than that, we are just going to use the same things. That is, we don't want this HTTP. You can see we are just fetching the put request response in HTTP variable. And if the HTTP code is greater than 0, we are just printing the response that we got. That is, the command that is updated will be directly printed over here in the serial monitor. If the HTTP code is not greater than 0, it will print the string HTTP error. And end, we are just terminating the HTTP connection with the end method. And this is the same function which is used for connecting the Node MCU to the Wi-Fi router. regarding this function, we are just using this function in each and every program till now from the beginning course of the lecture. And now you can see the logical part that we did for adding a command is, when I press on the button which is connected to D1, that is the digital pin 1 of NodeMCU, I will add the command L1 to the talkback queue. And when I press the button D2, or when I press the button which is connected to digital pin 2 of NodeMCU, I will add the command L2 to the talkback queue. So this was the logic that I built in the adding a talkback command lecture from our NodeMCU. Now what I'm just going to do is, I'm just going to update the command L1 when I press the button D1, and I'm just going to update the command L2 in the same command ID when I press the button D2. So here I'm just going to change this function name to be put update and in the initialization part you can see I'm just initializing the serial monitor for printing the response from the server, and here I'm just initializing two of the push buttons which has been connected to digital pin 1 and digital pin 2 with the pull up resistors internally, and here I'm just calling the Wi-Fi function for connecting the NodeMCU to the Wi-Fi router. And regarding the logical part, I'm not going to change anything. You can see when I press the digital pin 1 button, I will get the command L1 updated in the talkback queue right over here with the command ID 2333-2433. And when I press the button which is connected to digital pin 2, I will get the command L2 updated right over here. That is in this command ID 2333-2433. And similarly, again, when I press this button which is connected to digital pin 1, I will get the L1 updated over here. Again, when I press the button which is connected to digital pin 2, I will get the command L2 updated over here in the command ID 2333-2433. And if you want to replace the commands available over here, you just want to use this command ID over here instead of this command ID. So this is the only change that you want to make. So for each command ID, based on the command ID, we are just changing the commands available over here, or we are just updating the commands available over here with the help of the command ID available over here. And I have provided this program in the download button below this video, and you can download it. And you just want to change the required fields like API key, field number, SSID and password of Wi-Fi router for running your program on your IoT device NodeMCU. And if you are watching this video in the YouTube, you just want to enter my smtrainingacademy.com and then you just want to enroll for the required course, and each lecture is provided with a download button, and you can use that download button for downloading the resources for that particular lecture. This is the programming logic. Now I'm just going to dump the program to the NodeMCU. And that's it about the programming part. Now you can see here we are initializing the serial monitor and the buttons connected to D1, D2, and then we are connecting the NodeMCU to the Wi-Fi network by using this function called connect to Wi-Fi. And inside the programming logic part, we are just going to check for the D1. If this is pressed, we will load the L1 data to the respective talkback queue, and when we press this button connected to D2, I will load the command L2 to the talkback queue in the same command ID. And regarding this function, you can see I just want to comment this line. I forgot to comment this, it will be showing me an error. The program has been successfully uploaded. And now let's try to make the connection between NodeMCU and push buttons. You can see this is the push button that I'm going to use, and this is one of the contact of the push button, and this is the other contact. So this rail in the breadboard is connected to one of the contact of the push button, and this rail is connected to another contact. So one of the contact I'm just going to connect it to D1 of the NodeMCU, and regarding the other contact I'm just going to connect it to ground of NodeMCU. So you can use any one of the ground of NodeMCU. You can see here I am having a ground, here I am having a ground,
and also here I'm having a ground, here also I'm having a ground. So we can use any one of the ground. And regarding other end of the push button, I'm just going to connect it to D1 of the NodeMCU. I'm connecting this terminal to D1 of NodeMCU. And regarding the other end of the push button, I'm just going to connect it to ground of any one of the ground of NodeMCU. You can see I have connected one end to ground and other end to D1. And that's all. We have connected successfully one push button to D1 of the NodeMCU. And nextly, I just want to connect another push button, right? So I'm just connecting another push button right over here. You can see I'm just placing another push button near this push button available. And similarly, you can see this button also is having two terminals. This rail in the breadboard is connected to one of the terminals of the push button, and this rail is connected to another terminal of the push button. So I'm just going to connect one of the terminals of the push button to D2 of the NodeMCU right over here. That is the digital pin 2 of NodeMCU. And regarding the other end, as usual, we are just going to connect it to ground of NodeMCU, any one of the ground of NodeMCU. So I'm just going to connect one end of the push button to D2 of NodeMCU. And regarding the other end, I'm just going to connect it to any one of the ground of NodeMCU, right? So I'm just connecting it over here. You can see one end I have connected to D2, another end I have connected to ground. And that's all about the connections. I'm just going to power up my NodeMCU.
I'm opening the serial monitor. You can see my NodeMCU is trying to connect to the Wi-Fi router. And the connection is made. Now you can see this is my. So now you can see this is the talkback that we are going to change, and this is the command that we are going to change in our program. That is available in the command ID 2333-2433. And in my hardware, you can see this is the push button which is connected to digital pin 1, and this one is the push button which is connected to digital pin 2. So as per our program, we know that when I press this button which is connected to digital pin 1, I will get the command L1 updated in the command ID 2333-2433. And when I press this button which is connected to digital pin 2, I will get the command L2 updated in the same command ID 2333-2433. Now when I press this digital pin 1, you can see I got the response. That means the command has been updated. I am just refreshing this page. You can see the L1 is updated over here. And when I press the second button, the L2 has been got as a response in my serial monitor. You can see the L2 is loaded. Again, when I press the first button, I will get the L1 updated. You can see L1 is updated. Again, when I press the second button, I will get L2 updated. You can see I got L2. Again, when I press the button 1, I got L1. So this is the output that I got in the hardware. And using this programming function that we wrote, that is put update command, we are just sending a put request for updating a particular command in the talkback queue as per the command ID available over here. So these lines are useful for sending a put request to our talkback queue available in the ThinkSpeak server. And using this function call, you can send the required updations that you want to make in talkback queue commands. So I hope you understood this program. See you in the next lecture. Thanks for watching.